Louis Late was born in Bredstown in the Karoo, and from humble beginnings selling fertilizer, became a self-made multimillionaire. Late played a major role in non-racial rugby. He met several ANC leaders in exile. In 1988, he accompanied then SARFU president Dr. Danny Craven to Harare for a meeting with the ANC. They issued a joint statement afterwards, saying South African rugby should come under the control of a non-racial body. During the Thabo Mbeki lecture a few months ago, President Jacob Zuma said Late was one of the Afrikaners who accepted political change.
At the end, Louis Late stood up as we were about to part and shed tears after listening to Thabo, and he said, "But why such talent is left to be out of the country, not contributing our country?"
In 1989, Late entered rugby full-time as president of the Transvaal Rugby Union and was elected SARFU president soon afterwards. His biggest contribution to the sport post-isolation was securing the 95 Rugby World Cup for South Africa, which the Springboks won. Former President Nelson Mandela was at his side in the stands and during the trophy presentation. But 3 years later, they clashed in court. Late challenged a presidential appointed commission to investigate alleged racism, graft and nepotism in rugby. A high court judge decided in favor of Late, but the ruling was overturned by the constitutional court. Late resigned as SAFU president that same year after being accused of racism and financial mismanagement. He formed the Federal Alliance and became a member of parliament in 1999. His political career was brief. He survived by his wife, Adri, and 4 children. Pesinkatu, SABC News.